crazy day in the bond market as yields initially go down and then rally strong at the end of the day in a massive bond sell-off after a huge news day headlined by the Fed. And at this point right now, we are going to continue to see these crazy ranges, albeit probably with higher lows and higher highs in yields. So we did get back to 1% towards the end of the session today and blew right through it. The next key level is going to be 1.25%. And if you remember a few weeks ago, when we got through there back in February 28th, we traded south of 1.25%. We haven't been back since. That's a key level because globally, a number of other issues had gone through that level and never returned, including Germany, the UK, France, you name it. And so if the U.S. can get their yields back to 1.25% so quickly, it might mean that there's going to be some yield in this game. Obviously, the Fed has a lot to do with that. But certainly, if they're going to be buying more bonds, it's unlikely that those yields will creep up any higher than they already have today. But right now, we're seeing bond sellers late in the afternoon after seeing bond buyers earlier in the day. The ranges, again, remain very crazy and wide. And as you can expect, with crazy wide ranges, we have elevated volatility. Now it's down, you know, from those extreme highs, but we will continue to see volatility mark higher than we've known, you know, over the last several years, just out of the fact that the ranges continue to trade back and forth, especially in the back end of the curve where we saw limit down in bonds and in the ultra long bonds. But in the 10-year, we didn't get there. But it seems to me that right now the key is going to be how high can yields go, how low can prices go, with a Fed that's standing there ready to buy. So volatility is way off the highs, but still remains elevated. Ranges continue to widen and trade. Now, what is the cause of all this? Aside from the coronavirus, aside from the economic data, we have a Fed now that is going to be throwing everything at this market. They're going to be injecting money into the short end. They're going to be buying mortgages. They're going to be buying bonds. The federal government's going to be adding a stimulus package. So there is going to be a tremendous amount of capital available, tremendous amount of money pumped into the system. And while this could be short-term bullish, we may have a scenario that we had back in 2008, 2009, when this was the same menu they used to get us out of that crisis. And it took, you know, a decade to get rates nudged back higher, albeit that equities did see a nice run higher through that decade. But I'm not sure the market's going to be as welcoming this time because the idea here is that you want to get rates higher over a longer term period. We were unable to do that the last time, and this doesn't look like we're going to get out of these low rates anytime soon. So welcome back to ZERP, where we continue to hold zero interest rate policy. I think it's here for the longer term. Obviously, the Fed's doing whatever it can to stem off any economic recession. And given the environmental circumstances we have, and when we saw the retail sales number today, things look pretty bleak. However, they are coming to the rescue of the consumer. They are looking to keep the capital markets flush with dollars, and they do not want to fail in the system. So at this point, yields right now are probably trapped somewhere between 1 and 1.25. Maybe 80 basis points in 120 could be another range. We haven't gotten that high yet, but I do expect us to see more bond sellers as the week progresses. And at this point right now, it's going to be what will the market look like when the dust settles? Obviously, we don't know that yet. And as long as this coronavirus continues to hold our nation captive and the globe captive, it is going to be a very volatile, very choppy trade. So expect volatility to stay high, expect the Fed to stay active, and yields to remain in wide trading ranges without any kind of real sustained period at any one level. Not until the dust settles on this one, and we could be in this type of range for a long time, weeks and months possibly to come.